We're an enormously powerful creature. That we have 1.4 volt in every cell. We have 50 trillion cells, we have 70 trillion volts of energy. And as a result, we have an enormous energy field, which they call an aura. If you harnessed your understanding of energy, that you meditate and contemplate and try to connect your remedies, your cure all within yourself. The power is not out, your power is inside of you. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. And but for the grace of Allah that we are in existence, still in existence, that Allah's rahmah and mercy that forgives us and empowers us, gives us that force of life within our reality. If the servant enters into that love and respect and ihtiram for Sayyidina Muhammad, that's the ocean of power that Allah is dressing that reality. And everything is based on energy. Every condition that we find ourselves in has an energy. And when we go back and into the basics of energy and the understanding of energy, and away from the dogma of religion, that getting mixed in terms and terminology and people arguing based on terms, and the common denominator for our existence is a qudra, is an energy. Either you're building it or losing it. Someone's understanding of heaven and hell. Either you're building the energy or you're losing the energy. Adam al-Islam used to understand that reality. The world of Islam were deep in the reality of qudra and knowledges and energy. How is energy coming to you? What's the reality of your manifestation? Your manifestation is based on light, these atoms and energy. That energy is based on a resonance. This is all science. The resonance and the vibration is producing these energies. These energies produce these lights and atoms, and now your form is manifesting.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below. The programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Prophet ﷺ is describing that the sun will rise from the west, means there's going to be a shift. Everything is from showing the example on the horizon and within ourselves. So we have to see the spiritual shift before physical, otherwise that would be calamitous, that the whole world would collapse and nobody spiritually understood why. Always there has to be a spiritual isharat, guidance that prepares you for a physical event on the horizon. So spiritually only Allah and those trained by them are coming, and spiritual teachers are coming and showing. Do you see how it changed? You see how the East was about religion and spirituality, all Eastern culture. And they went after gold, money, high rises and extremism. And what was theirs, Allah shifted now into the West. And then the Western culture is trying to leave all those things. Most gold is bought in India and China for jewelry and consumption. Most amount of ultrasounds are sold in China and India because they want to kill the female child and raise only male adults. So all these signs are on that side now, and that the West is going to have ishraqiyoon. The West, Allah will raise them with knowledges. Means that when the Western reality begins to open, that we had all those material desires that didn't really bring us happiness, so there's going to be a collapse. And we want something of a spiritual reality. So what the East sold, they bought it. The East look at you and say, why you have this turban on, why are you wearing this beard, you have to be modern. And now all the Western people have beards. How's that? All of the Western men are starting to look like a quick conversion is coming. They're going to have realities and understanding and acknowledging deep realities that Allah want to give to them. So we see many signs of what Prophet was giving us of guidance from Holy Qur'an. That in the West the ulama are free to teach these haqqaiqs. And Allah's migrating them all into the West and teach and sit behind a couch and see if anyone's going to touch you. They like it, they don't like it, change a channel. But there's no mukhabarat coming to kill you the next day because they didn't like what you taught. So it means from the West Allah is sending all the scholars and the scholars of reality. Why? Because there's going to be a physical shift. And when that occurs, many things are going to be understood. But for now, the spirituality of it is awakening. So Prophet brought for us, we are energy beings sent onto this earth for a physical experience. We have a two-way ticket, not a one-way ticket. Allah sent the power into the womb, housed it with a flesh, brought it onto the earth, and then it's going to go back and leave its flesh vehicle and go back. And what it learned onto this earth, what it achieved onto this earth is its darajat and its reality. That many temptations are going to come to you on this earth, and if you can pull those negativities away and rise, then the energies that will be given to you are eternal, because the law of energy is that energy cannot be destroyed. So Allah reminding us in a very equal language for people, you are here to collect energy. And if you achieve positive energies, you know the law of energy, it will never be destroyed. Hasanat is never destroyed. Goodness and reward, whatever you did good, Allah keeps as in a bank for you. No, nobody can take that good away. Nobody can come and take your salah away, take your belief away, take whatever good you did in life away. You can throw darkness on it, but it doesn't take the good away. Means then spirituality comes and teaches, light up the darkness. Because you can throw darkness and darkness and darkness, but if the candle is lit, there's still light in that heart and there's nothing that can take that out. So then Allah giving for us that, come onto this earth and achieve your energy. And every time you achieve your energy, you're achieving something eternal. To go back supercharged, back to your destination, then your adventure only knows what's your next journey. So then we turned on television because the signs are going to come from everywhere. All of a sudden there's these professors of science talking energy, and they're saying that, oh, every cell has 1.4 volts of energy, scientifically they know, and that you have 50 trillion cells. So 1.4 times 5 is what? 70 trillion volts of electricity. So he says, we're enormously powerful creature. God has given to us in every cell 1.4 volts of energy, a qudra, a nazma, a chi, whatever they want to call it. All religions knew that. I'm watching this, you know, it's like a scientist trying to explain the hadith of Prophet says, there's the outside cure is not the one running to this person to give you a shot, this one to talk to you, this one to convince you, this one to say that you're crazy. But the energy is inside of you, the volts are moving inside of you, the field is all around you, you have to go in.
Rising Sun of the West is an essential spiritual guidebook filled with invaluable knowledge of the soul and the Divine's most powerful guiding light, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. The author guides the student through a comprehensive program of spiritual development and hidden realities of the soul. Available worldwide at Amazon.com.
When you go in, you have to be familiar with that energy, use that energy. You see, subhanAllah, these people are going to get it. And when they get it, they're going to go out and propagate it. And Allah will have people here from the world of Islam saying, we already had it. The Prophet prepared us for all of that. That qudra, that understanding is all there. Now if those on the other side forgot it, Allah has raised a group that they know qudra, they're trained in the qudra, they know how to reach to la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, illa billah. There's a secret. And who has that power? Allah's power flows through an energy source, because there has to be a central command for energy. If you can connect into that central command, and the only way through that central command is into your heart. Your heart has a connection into that central command of power. And the journey where Prophet taught that who knows himself will know his Lord, not Allah, he'll know his Rabb. Means he'll know that qudra which governs him. Because for you it's the Lord of power. Don't be confused with trying to know Allah or trying to even tap into Allah. Allah has a system, says, that waterfall will kill you with its force. You take ati Allah wa ati Rasul, the waterfall flows upon the Rasul and from the Rasul Wulul amri minkum, take from them and come to them with a spoon, a cup, a bowl, a hand, whatever you can take of your ability. So means this qudra, these energies, these teachings were flowing. They come and receive that energy. Go inside, tap into that energy and begin to use the energy. Use the energy to heal oneself. Use the energy to move that upon our being. Use that energy to move into the oceans of knowledges and realities. And what we talked is leave your particle life of everything being physical and enter the world of a wave. And then the tariqah comes with the huge science of that reality. One thing the scientist was missing is that in your energy field, yes, you must have 70 trillion volts, but how come you're not able to use them? Because they don't believe in something. What they don't believe in? Shaitan. So there's their deficit. So when Allah describes in Holy Qur'an that we have assigned a shaitan to everyone, which is the jinn who are marada, who are bad. A real shaitan would have destroyed you. A karin, kareem, I have assigned for every creation a nefarious being. He's your partner, you can't get rid of him. Nobody does not have that being. Now whether you're making him more powerful, then he is really coming after you, or you're depleting him. So the reason they can't use their 70 trillion volts, but awliya can, is they don't understand the concept of shaitan. They don't understand the concept of a negative being that Allah put next to us on this earth, knowing exactly how powerful you are. It's like a sci-fi movie now, right? You're immensely powerful from heavens and Allah putting you on this very fragile earth, and then we forgot how powerful we are. But Allah put like a regulator on us so that you don't use your full power and manipulate the systems of earth. You're coming down with the ulumul awwaleen wa akhireen. You're a descendant of Sayyidina Adam wa isma kullaha, that his knowledge and his qudra was far more powerful than the angels. When Allah gave the knowledges to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, said, I taught him isma kull, I taught him every knowledge. And the angels were astonished and made sujood, his qudra and darajat was much higher than angelic knowledges. And Allah said, bow down, to show the ihtiram of what this creation is carrying of realities. That creation came to this earth with an immense power, an immense ability. They don't understand how these things were made. Go research the pyramid. You think they made with a pipe and a rock? Where they can't lift the stone now, they can't lift the stone from the ground to put 200 feet in the different direction. In Jordan, the Petra temples, stones that are so massive, 10,000 tons, that they don't even have a device to lift this. Who was lifting and making these buildings? With what knowledge, with what power? They were moving rocks, moving things. So, mean Allah is giving for us, you were sent on this earth with a regulator. And this is your shaitan. So it means that when the soul is lit and Allah gives the power of its soul, the immensity of its power, that it can reach wherever Allah wants it to reach, its fires and its voltage can reach to wherever Allah wants to reach, and their nazar and their gaze can reach into the seven heavens, into the heart of Prophet with a qudra, with what? You have to use a power just to see the star. Then you have to use a telescope to see even farther than the star. How they're able to see into their heart, into the heavens, and to sit into the presence of heavenly realities with a power and a qudra that Allah giving to them. Feeding yourself is good for your stomach, feeding others is good for your soul. Go out and feed people. Go out and do selfless acts and help somebody. Sit and meditate and ask that, Ya Rabbi, I know, my Lord, I know that You put me in this ocean of power and I'm overcome. And ask that, oh my Lord, please, I'm overcome by this negativity, dress me, bless me, keep me within Your oceans of power. And then you meditate every day into that energy. Where Allah finds your struggle sincere, and as a result He sends a qudra into your heart and you immediately become heated. And every time you meditate you feel a heat on your hand and a heat on your neck, because this is Allah's qudra now coming. So it means there is an event arising, there is an event that happens in which the regulator is understood, shaitan is understood, shaitan is being brought down at every instant, and as a result your power is coming back up. And that's why it's so important that the tariqahs come and teach that don't let him win. Every time he wins your voltage went down, went down. Every time you listen to these horrible music and sounds your voltage is being taken down, because the sound and energy is most powerful right now. So then our whole life is about raising, raising the vibration, meditating, meditating, contemplating. And then when we begin to do our zikrs and our praise, what's happening? You raise the vibration. If the vibration, the chant and the praise is angelic, what is it doing? It's smashing all the lower vibration. Wajjal haq. When Allah is teaching from Holy Qur'an, tell them, when the truth comes, falsehood is perishing. The light then dresses their form. As a result, their light is not only for themselves, but whoever comes across them is being dressed by that light, because they have an abundance of the powerful light, a positive light. When you can barely power your own battery, how can you be of any benefit to anyone? So the most powerful solar company on earth right now is Naqshbandiyya Aliyya. When you sign up with them, they teach you, build your battery, build your capacity to take these energies. And in their association and in their zikr and in their trainings, they're sending these lights, sending these energies, sending these powers, at the same time building your capacity to hold the energy. Allah rigged the game for your victory. Every time shaitan take you down, it's 1 degree down. But then Allah said, just go do good and I'm gonna take you 10 degrees up. So hasanat has 10, down has 1. It's rigged in your favor. Give a zakat. Now we understand why Prophet said, give sadaqah. Because you're gonna go up 9, you just drop 1. If you want to be winning in your, it's like a financial market. If he shaitan took you down 1, go up 9 with 1 good deed. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati salamun alal mursaleen, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa, basir Surat al Fatiha.
With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate. As heavenly beings, We are on an eternal pursuit of angelic power. This book invites the seeker to attune to the guides of heavenly knowledge and discover the essential techniques we need to acquire to increase our positive energy within. In Pursuit of Angelic Power, available now on Amazon.com. If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of divinely knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.